Hello everybody, today we have a HP 250 G5 laptop that is not charging the battery, but it also won't power up with the charger connected. I don't usually deal with these things, but I was asked to take a look and see if I can discover what the problem is. I connected the charger and from what I saw, the plug moves very easily in the charger port. So I just moved it around to see if this would change anything, but the power LED was not coming on. Testing the charger with a multimeter showed that the outgoing voltage is okay and it's within the specifications printed on the brick. Looking at the plug does not reveal anything suspicious. Of course, there are some wear marks, but in the end the interior is clean and it should work in this condition. So I started suspecting that something in the charging port is so used that it's not making contact with the inside of the plug. There are two contacts that touch the inside of the plug, so I tried lifting them a little bit with a needle, but nothing has changed. After this, I remembered that we have another HP laptop and I should also try with that charger, but I found that there is a third contact which is missing from our plug and most likely it is in the charging port since I could not connect the other charger. I had a dead Dell laptop and from outside the plug seemed similar, so I decided to give it a go and see if these two can be swapped. I opened up the HP also. You should take care of these two screws hidden under the rubber pads next to the battery. It took me some time to find them. This laptop has a VGA connector, which comes out of the casing more than any other connector, and it's quite tricky to remove the case around it, so be careful. Taking a look after removing the base reveals that the charging port is positioned under the monitor's hinge and its cable runs together with the monitor and antenna cables right near to the cooling fan. In order to remove the hinge, the fan also has to come out. The charging port is connected to the board with a connector and comes out easily. Now I will remove the charging port from the Dell and compare them. I wasn't surprised that the connectors are different, but the port is also. One is connected with 3 wires and the other with 5. The HP port also has an LED and that is missing on the other, so it doesn't really make sense modifying anything. I went online and searched for the charging port. It is not an expensive part, but the problem is that it was not on stock and it would take up 30 days to receive it. I advise you to wait for the part and change it, if you don't really need the laptop. But in this case it was a must to get it working until the parts will come. I had the idea of connecting the charger directly to the board. So I cut the connector from the charger, as this was damaged anyhow, and with a multimeter set on diode, I tested the wires to the connector so I can identify the colors used. What I found is black from the charger is ground, this comes to the outside of the connector and to the black wires on the charging port. White from the charger is positive. This comes to the inside of the connector and to the red wires on the charging port. And finally, blue from the charger comes to the middle pin of the connector, the one that we are missing in this case, and to the brownish wire on the port. I drilled a 5mm hole through the port and fixed the cable from the charger with super glue. I soldered the wires together and used heat shrink to insulate them. After this, it was time to mount the port back with a cable attached. This was quite difficult as the heat shrink was taking up more space than the wires before, but in the end I managed to put back everything. I plugged the charger into the outlet and the LED powered up but went out after a short while. This was because the power button is located right under the hinge and the cables were pushing the board from the behind, keeping the button pushed all the time. I rearranged the cables. The button was working, but after mounting the case, this problem came back, making the laptop randomly power on and off. I took the port out again, got rid of the heat shrink and used simple PVC tape to insulate the cables, as this was way more flexible. This time the button worked just as it should, so I assembled everything back together. The downside is the notch I had to make in the base to accommodate the cable. Is this something I recommend doing? No. But if you have no other solution and the laptop is a must, this is what you could do. This is just a temporary solution and I will be changing the charging port when the part arrives. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video if you enjoyed it. Bye bye.